What up, you guys? I decided to do a video blog on the life of a brand new Oracle DBA, the best profession in the world, at least in my opinion anyways. But I said brand new because I am spanking brand new. To be honest, I did not know what DBA was until actually January of last year, and it's actually January 2013. I didn't find out until January 2012. So, within a year's time, I would say January from June, I studied, and I was able to successfully take two tests and get certified as an Oracle DBA. I ended up getting a job in September of last year. So, and it's January, so I've been a DBA for about 5 months, going on 6. Who am I? My YouTube channel is Oracle DBA Girl. As far as education experience, I don't have an IT degree. I don't have a computer science degree. I don't have any of those things, but I do have a psychology degree. So I do want to let you all know that you do not have to have an IT degree to be an Oracle DBA. As far as experience, 5 months in the game. That's it. And what I learned on my own. I've answered how long I've been a DBA certification. I do have the OCA, which is the first certification you can get as a DBA. Why y'all should listen to me? I'll go ahead and answer that question. Basically because I've seen what it takes to become an Oracle DBA. I see areas where people have failed. I know what I need to see. And that's the type of thing that I want to show you all, what you should do to succeed as an Oracle DBA. Why I decided to do this channel? I decided to do this channel because someone helped me. And I definitely appreciate the help that my mentor was able to give me. And I would want to give the same thing back to somebody. I would want to help people because I don't know if you all have been Googling, YouTubing, but I did all this just to see what people would say. I felt like, in a way, all this money they pay you is too good to be true. And I just wanted to know, is this for real? And I wanted to see what other DBAs would have to say about it. But for the most part, people will deter you from doing this job. I have no clue. It's I love it. I really love it. But I just really want to pay it forward and help people and just be an inspiration to people. Because if I did it, you can do it. What to expect from this channel? Basically, educational material. I really want to. This is right here. This is an introductory video. Once I'm done with this, I'm going to go on and let you know the things that you should be studying, how to study. I'm going to go on and tell you about your interview process because, believe it or not, that's the biggest thing ever. And that's where a lot of people fail. So we're going to talk about that, and I'm going to help you all set up a home environment where you can actually study using the server, Linux and all that. I'm going to show you step by step what you need. So that's what you can expect from this channel. The first requirement to be a DBA, I'm gonna be honest and tell you, is definitely hard work. Hard work. Dedication and hard work. You have to be dedicated to studying. I locked myself up in my room for 6 months to study. Once I saw how much my mentor made every paycheck, that was it. I was through. I didn't want to do anything else. Friend can wait. Everything else can wait. Why do you go to school? To get an education so you can do what? Get money. I mean, I did what I had to do. I locked myself up in a room for 6 months. I did what I had to do. I'm happy with where I am. And so, I'm just letting you all know it is hard work, but it's worth it. So, we're going to go ahead and move on. Alright, what is and what does an Oracle DBA do? Okay, I'm going to try to break this down and make it as simple as I possibly can. The main thing they do is just really manage data in the database. And I want to paint a picture for you all. So, think about Like when you go fill out a job application online, or when you're registering for school, or I don't know, anytime you're filling out something. When you put in that information, they ask you your name, your address, your birthday, all kind of personal information. When you hit submit, that information is stored in the database. So you have to think about it. Thousands and thousands and thousands of people are probably filling out for jobs and for school. And I'm going to refer to school a lot because I am young. I'm only 25 years old. And I'm at a point to where I do a lot of school and stuff. So you may hear me talk about school a lot, just to let you know. But anyways, going back to what I was saying, when you fill out this stuff, that information has to be stored somewhere. It's stored in a database. And you have 30, 40,000 people, sometimes 50,000, 60,000, 70,000. I mean, data can just be large. It can be huge, large amounts of data. That data has to be managed. Oracle DBA, they install databases, they configure databases, they upgrade databases, they move databases from one place to another place. You have to make sure that there's all kind of security set up on that database. You have to make sure that only the right people have access to what you want them to have access to. Storage and capacity. You have to make sure that your database can hold the information that is being put there. And if it can, you have to add more data to it. You have to add more data files to it. You have to make sure that the performance is right. When I say, okay, let's say I want to run a report on how many students, you know, is attending this school that are 20 years old. When I put in that, I want it to come back like this, ASAP. I want it to come back fast. If it's taking forever and ever and ever, then you have a performance issue. Database administrator, they have to do performance. They have to make sure that the performance is okay. Troubleshooting, to me, I'm going to be honest, that falls into more than one scope. That falls into hardware, software, database. You have to be sort of well rounded when it comes to troubleshooting, because sometimes, you know, it's other places like networking issues that could be causing the problem. So you have to be well-rounded. And that's just an overbrief of what a DBA do. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a link in the channel, and you can go to the link and get a more detailed view of what an Oracle database administrator do. Okay, we're going to talk about the different types of database. Now, I do want you all to realize that there are a lot of types of DBAs, but I'm only going to talk about two, and that's the core DBA and the application DBA. Core DBAs, they do all the things that I just mentioned to you. That's their job role. You also have the application DBA. I would be considered more of an application DBA. I deal with an application called Oracle E-Business Suite or Oracle Enterprise Business Suite. Basically, think about it in terms of filling out that job application online or applying to a school. It's an application that is going to handle that. We have to also be able to take care of the regular DBA tasks, but we also have to be able to troubleshoot that application if something goes wrong with it. We have to make sure that that application is running smoothly. We have to make sure that that application is not slow. So that's an application DBA. Like I said, this was just a introductory video. I want you all to subscribe, ask questions, comments. Again, my name is Oracle DBA Girl. You guys, I created this channel so that if you do have any questions, just ask. I can't answer any questions that I don't know about. I just want to help people because somebody helped me. I love my job. I love it with everything. And I think if you want to be an Oracle DBA, you can do it. You just have to have encouragement, and you have to have hard work and dedication. I'll be more than happy to help you in any way that I can. I will take this channel and answer as many questions as I can. So I check online every day. if y'all could just subscribe, comment, ask questions, I'll do my best to do the best job that I can. Again, this is Oracle DBA Girl. You all, y'all stay blessed. All right.